Welcome to New Hampshire's Business. I'm Fred Coker. There's a report out this year that there's a trend away from home ownership in New Hampshire by certain groups in our population and toward rental housing, and that has implications for the workforce and for the economy. Let's put a face on this, and here is the first graphic. Rental housing market in New Hampshire, vacancy rates down, but rents are up 10 to 15% across the state. Half of renters now pay more than 30% of income on rent, and most have to make over $46,000 a year to afford the median cost of a two-bedroom apartment with utilities. Now, that means there's a demographic and economic shift taking place. It reflects a trend away from ownership and toward renting. There's less need now for new home construction because that market is not as strong as it used to be, but there is a need for more rental housing construction. And take a look at this graph. This makes the point. This shows rental households in New Hampshire. On the left, year 2000, next to it 2005, and then it starts to go up, 2010 and 2013, which shows that the number of New Hampshire households increased by less than 5% between 2005 and 13, but renter households, and that's what this shows, increased by more than 15%. With me to talk about this is the person who christened that report, and he is Dean Christen, Executive Director of New Hampshire Housing, also known as the New Hampshire Housing and Finance Authority. Welcome.
Oh, thank you, Fred.
Nice to have you here.
Always happy to be here.
What's driving that trend?
There are a number of things. There are demographic changes that just are affecting our state across the board and the country in terms of aging population to a degree. People, as they get older, sometimes choose to become renters, and they're in the market seeking rental housing along with younger people. There's been this trauma, if you will, that affected a lot of people as a result of the housing recession, and people mm-hmm. decided that maybe being a homeowner wasn't such a good idea, and so they're taking a little longer to enter the home ownership market than they used to. There's a sense that people have that there's more mobility, there's more flexibility if they're renters than if they own a home. Mm-hmm. And frankly, a lot of young people are challenged to become first-time buyers because of high levels of student debt. New Hampshire has actually the highest levels of student debt in the country. And because of other changes in the mortgage markets that have made it a little more difficult for people to perhaps get that first home. So you put all that together, you have more people in that rental market than used to be the case.
Let's put a graph up. This shows the New Hampshire rental housing vacancy rate starting way on the left at 1990 and ending in 2015 way on the right. And the blue line shows all housing units, and then the red line is two-bedroom rental units. And you can see the vacancy trend is down.
Yeah, and vacancy rates like this are actually quite startling. I mean, nationally, even as this trend has evolved nationally, people see a 5 or 6% vacancy rate as being kind of a normal, balanced mm-hmm. market. We're looking at numbers here in the twos and in some market areas of the state well under 2% for vacancy. So that's not even turnover. That's even less than turnover, if you will. It means that it's very tight.
Suggests the need for more apartments, more rental housing.
It's a supply and demand dynamic, obviously. Yep. And so rents go up when vacancy rates are this low. It also challenges people to be able to find a rental unit that's somewhere that is workable for them in terms of distance to their work and things of that nature.
This last graph shows the cost. The New Hampshire statewide medium gross rental cost starting in 1990 on the left and going to 2015 on the right. And you can see back in 1990, the rent for rental units or two-bedroom units, which is the red line, was between $600 and $700. It's now over $1,157.
Yeah, so rent numbers are for, and this is obviously statewide numbers. It varies dramatically by market area, but a two-bedroom rent is probably around $1,100. All rents are a little less than that. Mm-hmm. The fact is, again, as I said earlier, supply and demand. If you have a low supply relative to demand, your prices are going to go up. It's a commodity.
What do we do about this? Because this really affects workforce. It's a disincentive for workforce, for young workforce.
Well, the primary way you can address this in the short term is by building more rental housing. There needs to be an increase in the supply of that housing in our markets. And that requires the private sector to step up and do that because they build most of that housing. The challenge that they face is getting permits for rental housing and the cost dynamics. Can you build it at a level that actually will work given what people are able to pay?
We're out of time, but I hope we've done justice to this issue. Dean Christen, Executive Director of New Hampshire Housing, thank you.
Thank you.
And if you want to see some of those charts again up close, you can go to WMUR.com, click on News, and then click on Project Economy.